of the North Sea stands Lyme Colliery. Off shift at tea time goes underground worker Harry Brown, home to his family at Newbiggin by the sea, a few miles south along the coast. Out on the cold waters, two men in a small boat have come to grief on a fishing trip. The Newbiggin lifeboat picks up their signal and the alarm is sounded. Out dashes stoneman Henry Rowe and transit worker James Arkle. Between them, they can number 30 years volunteer membership in the lifeboat service. Other miners come running in at the double to Newbiggin's lifeboat station. Launching Newbiggin's 17,000-pound lifeboat is a well-rehearsed and critically timed operation. To every man on the crew falls his allotted task. Coasting the boat down to the beach is the quickest part of the drill. Then she has to be manhandled along the intervening stretch of shingle and sand with the help of a caterpillar tractor which will launch her into the waves. The turnout of the lifeboat is an occasion when local people are always on hand to help. Rough seas or calm seas, the sturdy Richard Ashley can take them all as they come. Once in the water with engines thundering, Harry Brown, with 25 years lifeboat service, can take a breather while others in the crew step the mast. Close now to the distressed dinghy, a heaving line is thrown aboard, and the tow homeward can start. Not a very spectacular rescue, perhaps, but maybe two more lives were brought safely to the shore, and who knows how many it might be next time. Whatever the weather, by day or by night, the men of Newbiggin Lifeboat and of every lifeboat stand ready to go to the help of those in peril on the seas. The minor members of the crew may find at any time they are wanted on sea shift in the North Sea, far above the seams of their own collieries, searching not for coal, but for mariners in distress.